foremost, I'd like to strongly warn Emmanuel Malite and Mr. Akafumba to say that the NDC is not something that they should play with. You know, just because they supported the UPND, they think that now they can use all sorts of unlawful means, you know, to grab the NDC away from its lawful owners. You know, the NDC has a constitution, the NDC has a disciplinary code of action, the NDC is a fully registered party in this country. Mr. Akafumba was expelled first by Central Committee that sat in Luansha, and then by the other members of the office bearers who sit on the Register of Societies, and then by the convention which was held in Kitwe. So he's an expelled member of the NDC. They went ahead, masqueraded as NDC, even supported the ruling party, and now they think that because the UPND won, they can go ahead and start doing all sorts of things. We have seen that from the time that the UPND won, they are all over, you know. And we know for a fact that the alliance partners were only given two slots as ministers. So Mr. Akafumba is trying to show relevance so that he's going to be one of the two alliance partners that is going to be given those two seats as ministers. Let me warn Mr. Akafumba. There are so many things that he has done in trying to get the NDC, which have been very illegal, but we've just been keeping quiet and watching him. But now let me tell Mr. Akafumba that we're not going to go ahead and watch him. It is our hope as NDC that President HH is going to appoint him minister or whatever it is that is going to appoint him, so that he stops masquerading as NDC. Today they paraded some people, I think some MPs who stood in Chifunabuli on NDC, and started claiming that I misled those people to stand on NDC. First and foremost, these are people who I don't even know that are members of the NDC. I am a leader in the NDC, but I don't know everyone. So everyone who stood on NDC stood because they aspired to be members of parliament, because they were councillors or whatever it was. NDC had over 50 people that stood as MPs and councillors, mayors and all sorts of positions. The only place you do not field in a candidate was the issue of the presidential candidate. So now for them to parade people on social media, on our mainstream media, to claim all sorts of things, it shows how unlawful they are. And for me, this is an indictment on President HH and the UPND. They claim to be a party that follows the rule of law. President HH, he has been talking about integrity and following the rule of law. So this thing with the NDC and Mr. Akafumba, I think the UPND and President HH, they need to come in, because these people are using them as a UPND. They're using them as a President HH to do all sorts of unlawful things, you know. So as NDC, let me once again warn Mr. Akafumba. Warn Mr. Akafumba to stay from the NDC. And as a woman leader, I feel so sad that I even have to be drawn into such kinds of politics. This country should move away from such kind of politics and concentrate on issue-based politics. But now, because young boys like Malite are being sent by Mr. Akafumba and they're doing all sorts of things. And I know, for example, again, that so much money has been put into the NDC for them to cause confusion. So the question I have is this: who's giving them that money? Is it Mr. Akafumba or is it the UPND? So the UPND should be seen to play clean politics. They just won elections, and the first thing that they're doing should destabilize the NDC. So for me, I'd like to warn Mr. Akafumba and Emmanuel Malite, as well as caution the UPND, to say the things that these people are doing are looking very bad on them. So they need to control the situation.